Welcome. In wake of the capture of Wing Commander by Armed Forces of Pakistan, we have brought about this topic, that is Geneva Convention, very, very important for all your competitive upcoming examinations. Now, before we begin with Geneva Convention, let's talk about the three terms, protocol, treaty and convention. What's the difference between the three? So, treaty, I can say simply it's an agreement between the two parties. They are there to resolve any kind of disputes and disagreements or conflicts that exist. Convention, on the other hand, is for a specific purpose, a specific objective, where international meeting of the representatives takes place. So, for example, you have the convention for wetland. So, that's for a specific cause and it's known as Ramsar Convention. Similarly, you have Geneva Convention for the victims of the war as well as the civilians. Similarly, you have protocol. Now, protocol is an agreement that is signed on the basis of the treaty or the convention. So, it's a kind of final format to a treaty or a convention, we can say. And this is very, very important because you have the diplomatic negotiators who come upon an agreement and finally this protocol comes into being. Now, we would be focusing on Geneva Convention for this class. So, Geneva Convention could be explained under four conventions and three protocols, which are really, really important. This Geneva Convention is applied or is the basis of the international humanitarian law, where we are talking about the right treatment to the civilian and the soldiers during a wartime. Now, it is applied not only to a wartime, but also in the peaceful time and an armed conflict situation as it appeared recently. So, we talk about understanding the convention where the wounded and the sick persons, be it on land or be it on sea, are taken into consideration. The immunity is given to one who is captured. You have a proper treatment that is provided. The civilians are protected. And also you have a symbol that is being recognized. And this acts as an equipment for helping the personals. In this reference, you have a term which is known as horse G combat that is used. Now, what is this horse G combat? Horse G combat is a term which is used in French diplomacy, and it basically means people who are incapable to perform during the wartime, and that's the hostage combat, and therefore you have the humanitarian cause that comes in. International humanitarian law, which is also known as the law of war or the law of armed conflict, is important because it provides or protects the people who are involved in the hostilities or the warlike situation. The next important thing is the start of Geneva Convention. So, it started very first with the 10 articles back in 1864. However, it was ratified in 1949 and finally came into force in 1950s. During that time, 74 states were party to it. Later, few other states joined during the various decades, as you can see. And finally, as of now, you have 196 nations which are party to it. Now, this was the party to the conventions. Then you had three protocols that came up. Two protocols came back in 1977 and the other in 2005. These protocols also have different numbers of members. So the first protocol had 174 nations that ratified it. The second protocol was ratified by 168 nations and the last protocol was ratified by 75 nations. So that's the basic statistics. Now, across all the conventions that exist, there is a common Article 3. Now, this common Article 3 for the first time covered a situation for non-international conflicts that can occur during this time. So, it requires treatment of a person in the enemy hand. So, the person who is into the enemy hands must be treated. The wounded or the sick must be taken care of. International Committee for Red Cross would be providing services to the party of the conflict, and that's very, very important. So everything should be taken care by the International Red Cross, International Committee for Red Cross. So that's a kind of common background of Article 3. Very, very important because it's applicable to all the four conventions. Now let's first talk about the four conventions. The first convention talks about protecting the wounded, the sick soldiers on the land during the wartime. So this is important. This is only on the land. It has how many articles? It has 64 articles. That's again important. It has two annex that are there, and they are a kind of draft agreement relating to the hospital zones, the protection of an individual identity. So this includes the wounded, the people who are helping the wounded, the civilians who spontaneously take up the arms in order to protect themselves or repel a kind of invasion that's coming up. So those all categories would fall under the first convention of the Geneva. Under the second convention of the Geneva, the protection is for the wounded at the sea during the wartime. Now how many articles are there? 63 articles are there under convention 2. So the second convention has 63 articles. This has replaced the Hague Convention, which was there for 1907. So Hague Convention that was previously there has been replaced. And this Hague Convention for the adaptation of maritime warfare was important because it protects the people in hospital ships. So hospital ships become important, and this is not for any kind of religious or personal motive. Okay, so there is a kind of role model card that is being provided to the people. The next or the third convention talks about prisoners of war. It has 143 articles that are party to it, and it replaced the prisoners of the war convention, which had only 97 of the articles. So it's talking about the labor of the prisoners and the financial resources, the relief they receive, the judicial proceedings that happen. So everything related to prisoners of war is covered under the third convention of Geneva. It also has five annexes that are there for the model regulations and the cards. The fourth convention is pretty important. Now, when this convention came into force, it was after the Second World War. It was realized that the civilians are also hit badly during wartime, and therefore protection of the civilian, the common people in the occupied territory becomes important, and this came in the wake of the Fourth Geneva Convention. So it talks about the general principles where protection of the people, the civilian people becomes important, and this also had three annexes that were there. So three annexes and 159 articles which were party to it, which provided protection to the civilians for humanitarian cause, humanitarian relief purpose. Now besides this, there were protocols. As we said, protocol describes a rule how the thing should happen, or it's a kind of international courtesy rule, which we can say. So there were three protocols that were brought. The first two protocols came back in 1977, so they were much ahead of the third protocol that came in. The first protocol was for the international conflict, the second was for the non-international conflict, and protocol 2 was the first ever international treaty devoted to a situation of non-international armed conflict that could occur, and therefore it's important. And in the protocol 3, we talked about an additional symbol, and this was laid down in 2005. Now understanding this is important. Let's first talk about the Red Cross. So Red Cross was the first symbol that was given by Henri Dunant, and this symbol is the reverse of a Switzerland flag. So you have red boundaries with white cross, and this is just a reverse of it. So any wartime situation, you would see a medical personnel coming with a red cross, and that's for the medical help. So that person would not be affected during the wartime situation. However, later on, it was believed by some countries, mainly the Ottoman Empire during that time, that this symbol was trying to alienate the Muslim population, and therefore they created their own symbol, which was known as Red Crescent. So the new symbol that came in was Red Crescent. After the fall of Ottoman Empire, this was used by Turkey, it was used by Egypt, and many other nations slowly and gradually, including Pakistan, adopted the Red Crescent. Later on, it was further believed that there should be a kind of neutral symbol that should be there. And so a new symbol came up, and this symbol was what was known as the red crystal. Previously it was known as a red diamond or a red Lawrence, but later on it was renamed as red crystal. So these three are protective and indicative symbols, and the last symbol that we have here for a star is a only a indicative symbol that's there. So either of these symbols work well, and all of those indicate a humanity cause or a cause to help the people who are victims of war, who are civilians, who were caught up during the wartime. So that's a very, very important session. Now, India is a party to all the four conventions. That's again very important topic. It has not still ratified the protocols. So that's again important. The apprehensions and the fear of not ratifying are still there. So those are some things that we would be discussing in a separate class. As far as your examination perspective concerns, you have the important topics on the major conventions. What is the major idea in each of the conventions, the three protocols, the three symbols, the differences between the three symbols, and why these symbols came up. So that's a basic backdrop of the whole concept. A difference between protocol, treaty and convention indeed is really important, not only for this but for various environmental programs that we have been talking about. We'll be coming up with many recent classes, contemporary topics in GS. So stay tuned. Have a wonderful day ahead.